Hello students, myself Dr. Sheetal Kulkarni and I am going to teach you life support instrument ventilator systems. Mechanism of respiration, introduction, patient circuit, organs of respiratory and artificial ventilation. Respiration is the process of supply oxygen to and removing carbon dioxide from the tissues. These gases are carried in the blood oxygen from the lungs to the tissues and carbon dioxide from the tissues to the lungs. The gas exchange in the lungs are called external respiration. Those in the tissues are called internal respiration. There is a very delicate balance between the absorption and excretion of oxygen and carbon dioxide in the lungs and the tissues. This balance is maintained by the respiratory or breathing activity. Conducting section. This includes the nasal activities, pharynx, larynx, trachea, bronchi, bronchioles. These organs are thick-walled and do not participate in the gas exchange to capillary. Respiratory section. This include respiratory bronchioles, alveolar ducts, and alveolar sacs. These contain thin walls and permit gas exchange to the blood capillaries. The lungs consist of two cone-shaped and spongy organs that contain the alveoli, that is air sacs, that trap air for gas exchange with the blood. The lungs are covered by a smooth glistening membrane called pleura. This turns back at the root of each lung and covers the inner surface of the chest wall. Normally, there are two layers of pleura, moist membrane and a visceral membrane pleura, which covers the lung surface, and partial pleura which lines the thoracic cavity. The fluid line space between the two membranes accounts for easy spillage between the lung and the chest wall during breathing. The lungs are normally stretched or expanded against the resistance of elastic fibers, inspiration and expiration. Two sets of muscles involved are the diaphragm that moves up and down and the intercostal muscles that move the rib cage in and out. Inspiration results from contraction of the diaphragm and intercostal muscles, whereas expiration results from their relaxation. There is no active participation of the lungs in the movement. The rate and the depth of breathing are controlled from the brain in the medulla region. The control impulses reach respiratory muscles via spinal cord, control the contraction of the diaphragm and raise the ribs to increase the thorax cavity. Artificial ventilation. For reduced breathing or respiratory failure, the mechanical devices or respirators are used in the hospitals. These devices provide artificial ventilation, supply enough oxygen and eliminate the right amount of carbon dioxide, maintain the desired arterial partial pressure of the carbon dioxide and desired arterial oxygen tension. Mechanical aids for manual artificial ventilation consist of a mask, breathing valve and self-filling bag. The mask, which is of soft rubber or plastic, is held firmly over the patient's mouth, nose so that it fits tightly. The breathing valve serves to guide the air so that fresh air or air in reach with oxygen is supplied to the patient and expired air too is conducted away. The bag is squeezed with one hand and functions as a pump. It is self-expanding and fills automatically with fresh air or oxygen when the patient breathes out. Ventilators. When artificial ventilation needs to be maintained for a long time, a ventilator is used. Ventilators are also used during anesthesia and are designed to match human breathing waveform pattern. These are sophisticated equipment with a large number of controls which assist in maintaining proper and regulated breathing activity. For short-term or emergency use, recurtition or are employed. These depend upon mechanical cycle operation and are generally lightweight and portable. The main function of receptor is to ventilate the lungs in a manner as close to the natural respiration as possible. Since natural inspiration is a result of negative pressure in the pleural cavity generated by the movement of the diaphragm, ventilators are initially designed to create the same effect. The ventilators are also called as negative pressure ventilators In the design, the flow of air to the lungs is facilitated by generating a negative pressure around the patient's thoracic cavity. The negative pressure moves the thoracic walls outward, expanding the intrathoracic volume and dropping the pressure inside the lungs, resulting in a pressure gradient between the atmosphere and the lungs, which causes the flow of atmospheric air into the lungs. The inspiratory and expiratory phases of the respiration are controlled by cycling the pressure inside the body chamber. Positive pressure ventilators generate the respiratory flow by applying positive pressure greater than the atmospheric pressure to the airways. The principal positive pressure ventilator, during the inspiration, the inspiratory flow delivery system creates the positive pressure in the patient circuit, and the exhalation control system closes the outlet to the atmosphere. There are two types of ventilators. Anesthesia ventilators, these are generally small and simple equipments used to give regular assisted breathing and during an operation. Intensive care ventilators are more complicated, give accurate control over a wider range of parameters, often incorporate patient triggering facility. The ventilator delivers air to the patient when the patient tries to inhale. Ventilator terms: lung compliance. The compliance of the patient lung is the ratio of volume delivered to the pressure rise during the inspiratory phase in the lungs. This includes the compliance of the airways, and compliance is usually expressed as a liters per centimeter H2O. Lung compliance is the ability of the alveoli and lung tissue to expand on inspiration. The lungs are passive, but they should stretch easily to ensure the sufficient intake of the air. Airway resistance. To the ease with which the air flows through the tubular respiratory structures, higher resistance occurs in smaller tubes such as bronchioli and alveoli that are not emptied properly. Mean airway pressure, an integral taken over one complete cycle, expresses the mean airway pressure. Inspiratory pause time. When the pressure in the patient circuit and alveoli is equal, there is a period of no flow. This period is called inspiratory pause time. Inspiratory flow. Inspiratory flow is represented as a positive flow above the zero line. Expiratory flow is the negative flow below the zero line. Tidal volume. Tidal volume is the depth of breathing or the volume of gas inspired or expired during each respiratory cycle. It can be calculated by multiplying the flow rate liter per second setting by the set inspiratory time in seconds. Calibrated tidal volume settings range from 0.010 liter to 4.8 liters. If the flow rate is set at 0.616 liter per second and inspiratory time is set at 1 second, then the tidal volume is equal to 0.6 liter. Minute volume. This refers to the volume of gas exchanged per minute during quiet breathing. Minute volume is obtained by multiplying tidal volume by breathing rate. Respiration rate. This is the number of breaths per second. It represents the total respiratory rate of the patient. This control mode, SIMV, synchronized intermittent mandatory ventilation mode, the ventilator measures the previous four breaths and shows the average total rate. Conventional mechanical ventilation, CMV. It provides a force which determines the tidal volume and the respiratory frequency to achieve the desired minute ventilation. Intermittent mandatory ventilation, IMV. It allows the insertion of a variable time delay between each breath. Inspiratory expiratory phase time ratio. This significance, the ratio of inspiratory interval to expiratory interval of a mandatory breath. This ratio is normally limited to 1:1. The inspiratory time should not exceed 50% of the total ventilator cycle time as set by the breath per minute control. Synchronized intermittent mandatory ventilation. It represents combination of machine ventilation and spontaneous breathing. SIMV enables the patient to breathe spontaneously in regular prescribed cycles with a mechanical mandatory ventilation strokes, providing a minimum ventilation during the remaining cycles. Peak airway pressure. It is the highest level of pressure reached over several breaths. spontaneous ventilation. This is a ventilation mode in which the pressure initiates and breathes from the ventilator at will. Bias flow. In the bias flow, mixed gas from the mixture is redirected through the patient circuit in between mechanical breath. Bias flow stabilizes baseline pressure. Sensitivity. It is used to detect spontaneous effort by the patient in order to trigger mandatory ventilation with a set of respiration rate. MMV, mandatory minutes volume ventilation. This operates mode applies mandatory ventilation if spontaneous breathing is not yet sufficient, has fallen below a pre-selected minimum ventilation. Controlled mandatory ventilation. This term refers to the mandatory ventilation of patients who are not able to initiate or respire on their own. Assisted spontaneous breathing, ASB. It refers to the pressure support of sufficient spontaneous breathing. Positive ends expiratory pressure, PEEP, is a therapy selected pressure level for the patient airway at the end of expiration in either mandatory or spontaneous breathing. PEEP is used to increase the end expiratory lung volume. Continuous positive airway pressure is in which the ventilator maintains a constant positive pressure near a volume below PEEP level in the patient airway while the patient breathes out. Assist and control ventilation. During this process, the positive pressure breath is delivered with each patient's spontaneous inspiratory effort to reach the trigger level setting.